Hey everybody, I'm Mama Baird. Welcome back to the channel. Today, it's all about picking up some old canning jars for free. So let's get into it and let's see what goodies I got. Look at all. I'm guessing like 200 jars. Wow. Still see the peaches.
Yeah, I've been finding all kinds of treasures in these things here.
Wow.
Some of them hadn't been opened up in 65 plus years. I just found this morning.
Wow.
And that.
What is that?
It's like a perfume bottle.
Wow. That is pretty cool. Right. And it's just from this cellar down here?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it was all locked up.
Did you just buy this place?
No, this is the Boyer Ranch.
Okay.
It's been in their house for generations, and they just open it up and cleaning it out and remodeling it.
Well, good for them.
It was built in 1806.
1806. Look at these geese right now.
Is what I've kind of looked up online.
Okay.
It would be the last two numbers, I believe, in the numerals.
Okay.
But this is a duraglass, and they're...
Wow. They're really I've never seen one of these.
Have you ever seen an atlas?
Yes. Yes. I've seen an atlas.
Okay.
What year is this from again?
1967.
Wow.
June 4th. Oops.
That's crazy. Carpet sale, $666.
$666 a square yard.
Wow. That's funny. That used to be the entertainment. People would read the paper.
Forever, yeah.
Whew, a bit of progress. Still got some more. One of the lids already popped open. Some kind of fruit. There's like a brain in there. All right, well, we are all locked and loaded. They're not burnt, they're rusty. They're rusty because they've been sitting in a dirty cellar for 65 years. Yep, you ready to go? Let's get out of here. Now this was just the beginning. Let the work begin. Hey everybody, so it's the next morning. I'm here with all these jars. I want to get all the rust cleaned off of them and get them cleaned up, get all this food disposed of, but Montana has decided that it's time to rain. Luckily for us, Vevor has sent us this carport to give a try. So now's the perfect time to get it unpacked and get it put up. So let's go over here and let's see how complicated this thing is to put together. It comes with this bag that has all the gadgets and gadgets, bolts, ropes. Looks like it comes with a pair of gloves too. That's pretty nice. The one thing I don't see are instructions. Well, let me get husband up, get some coffee in him, and then hopefully he knows how to put this together without instructions, or we'll have to look it up. Or he can find the instructions, because I cannot. So let me get him up and going, and then he'll be out here, and we'll get this thing put together before it really starts coming down. Come on. Hey, you hit it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You want to put this? The one you need to ball?
6, and then all the feet. Alright, keep this box up. This is trash. Okay. Oh, these snap together. They're not bolts.
Oh, that's good.
It's not all bolts.
Good.
They're white gloves.
Yeah, they sent us 2 pair.
The white gloves treatment.
We were first a little worried about this because we thought we were going to have to put bolts in every single hole, but as you heard, that they snapped together, which made it really convenient. Everything was labeled like 2 and then 2A, so you know that those match and have to go in together. And we found the instructions, so that's good. It was like buried in one of the top boxes, one of the flaps. And this was just an activity that the whole family ended up getting into, and we were all passing the rods to husband and putting them together, and it was really fun and super easy, and I'm glad that we were able to give this a try and get us some cover for the upcoming winter. Okay, get out of the way.
I love you, baby.
I love you.
The rod right there, the big one, buddy.
Oh. Number 4 on it.
You need to walk it in the
bolt.
Oh.
Yeah.
Got it. Okay.
Nut.
Nut. Is this? Oh, you need a nut up.
Nope, nope, that's it. The one you had. Yep, that's nut. Wing nut.
I know. Why is she only called it nut instead of a wing nut? Whose idea was to have a go at?
Not mine. Do you think, husband, is pretty easy to put together so far?
Yeah, it's pretty easy to put together. Not too bad.
Nice. We found the instructions, too. You helping, Conrad?
No.
No?
Yes. Well, my dad's rebuilding it. I'm not giving that as a piece.
That's important. That's an important job.
So, Bracket. That...
Dang it.
I can find the bolts. How did the mailman carry that if it was so heavy? Boat.
Right there. Now I'm picking that one up.
Yeah. Oh, that's a nut. Sorry.
Rude.
Here, Conrad.
Thanks.
Here,
it's not a bolt. So the straps wrap around, and that's what helps keep it on.
Yep.
Yep. The balls.
The balls.
Yep. These are.
That's a pretty nice, creative solution.
Yeah. Instead of like a zip tie or something.
Can you help me put on my
nut? Strip down my butt crack.
Great family content right here. Okay, Connor, come here.
One more. Bolt.
Lock.
And this is all the giblets.
Giblets.
Yeah.
Good work, team. And just like that, husband built a carport. Good job, husband. Round of applause for husband. Yay. All right, well, I better go feed the man, and then we're gonna break out these jars and we're gonna see what they're all about and what goodies are inside. And we're gonna possibly have a puke bucket. Hey everybody, so the car carport is up. Yay! Good job, husband. So I am going to get in here and I'm going to start getting into these jars some. I'm probably not going to be able to get to cleaning all of them right now, but we can start getting a couple of loads washed and we'll see how old these jars really are. Let's get in here and I'll kind of show you close up what these look like. Okay, now this one still has pickles. Looks like onions, cucumbers. Yeah, that's what it looks like in there. Cherries. Stored with the ring on. Still sealed. Let's just say, I think what I'm going to do and take all these out. We did not get all these out of the rain before it started raining on them. Look at this one, just pure black tar where you can tell this one has gotten. It literally just falls apart. Oh my gosh. So that did not hold up. Need to get some tongs to get some of that stuff out. Okay, I'm going to kind of spray these off. There we go, but look at that old jar. It says 9B on it. And then this, let's see. Crosses cut dill pickle columbium. So they just have some pretty big jars. 222 NW4 down here. Wow, look at that lid. All right, how about one that's, oh. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get this off. Oh, I did. Nothing a little towel. Yeah. Let's use my jar opener. Oh. It's a lid. All right, guys. Let's give it a smell.
So when you guys told me not to smell this, I'm smelling it. Oh, it does not stink. Wow, look how mushy though. I'm pretty sure these were pears. 65-year-old pears at least. And they made it, it was sealed. Wow. Good job, Grandma. Great Grandma? Great Great Grandma? Man, but I'm gonna throw this food away. I'm not gonna give it to the chickens either, just in case. Which I feel bad, because someone put a lot of work into that. And then here is an old fashioned, like you can just tell by the lip how awesome this jar is. This is 8B. Yeah, there's an old ball jar. I'm gonna do the cherry one. Yeah, it had a seal. Oh, it's pretty on there. Smells fine too. 65-year-old flat. Oh, these still have the pit in them. They didn't pit them. Don't blame them. That's a lot of work. So they just put whole cherries in there and then some kind of sweet brine. Wow. I wonder if you can plant these seeds and grow a tree. Maybe I should save some just to see. Wow. Montana cherries that are 65 years old. I am just blown away by all this. That's just cool. Squeeze all these out. All right. Oh, this kills my heart to toss them. Look at that. All right, let's do the pickles now. Nope.
1965. That's older than my parents. My dad was born in 60 and my mom in 59. Oh my gosh. This is why you don't storm with the rings on. Okay, that one's not coming off. Woo! I don't know what to do in that instance. That one won't come off. Get husband to manhandle it. Do some more cherries. So a lot of you were suggesting with the rust that you could either use baking soda with vinegar or use Barkeeper's Friend are the two best suggestions. Not best, but the two suggestions that I got. All the other ones sucked. Kind of weird how it just eats through it, and then look at all that food, just like black tar.
Well,
all right, so that's sprayed off. Let's see if any of this wipes off. The inside's wiping. Now, glass is completely cleanable, guys. I know some people might be worried that this is going to contaminate the glass and all the food's going to be bad that may later on get it. But glass does not absorb any kind of smells or, well, I mean, it could absorb some smells, but you just use baking soda and that helps get it out. I'm going to put it in my bucket here. Some baking soda. I've never tried this before, so let's give it a try. Then I have a little stainless steel scrubby here. That rust seems to be coming. Whoa, calm down, Carolina. All that rust kind of came off the bench there. And then you just check for like any chips or cracks or anything. And get some tongs or something to push that in there. And then I'm going to put all these through the dishwasher. Give them a nice clean cycle and they should all be ready to go. So it says C11. I'm going to look up how to read these. Oh, that's a G. Oh no, it's a 6. 6A. Dang, I don't know how to read them. I got to look that up. Hey, look, and that rust just comes right off the edge of the jar. Well, guys, that baking soda and vinegar worked really well. The rust is off. I'm probably going to have it soaked and do a little more in here. And then I'm going to have them soak in hot, soapy dish water as well. And then I'm going to run them through the dishwasher. I am not going to do all this now, though. I'm going to bring everything in under the rain. I'm going to slowly kind of work at it. I'll probably do like maybe 2 dozen at a time. I'm definitely going to do the ones that have the food in, though, get that kind of all dumped at once and then get those cleaned. So that's probably 2 dozen or something there. I think I'm going to do, I kind of want to do a jar count for you guys, though, and see how many I got. Oh, boy. I don't know. Should I spread them all out? I don't want to commit to that kind of tasks. Let's see. We got tomorrow, too. All right, I'm going to go ahead and spread them all out, and we'll count up how many we have because I'm curious. I'm sure you are as well. So let me pull them on in here. We'll get all this organized, and then I'll give you a tally. Presto. Wide mouth glass top. Wow. Look at this old dressing, 1 pint Miracle Whip salad dressing, Kraft, salad oil, water, vinegar, sugar. It doesn't have a year on it. It says 1214 here, but pretty cool. Here's another one. Hormel Good Food. All right, everybody. So I put the first load in the dishwasher. They are sparkly, shiny as new. Some of them still have some rust on top where I'm going to have to soak them. Husband suggested CLR, so that might be something that I will do. I will keep you updated on the best way to get the rust off of this. But so far, just putting them in baking soda and vinegar and giving them a scrub and then hot soapy water, scrubbing them. Did a great job. I used a green scratch pad as well as a stainless steel to get this rust off. A lot of it was up and under the lips here, but they came completely clean. And then I did do some research. And the bottom number on here, hello, is actually the model number. So this is the model that they used to make this particular jar. And then husband and I determined by looking up through the label on the jar is how you can determine what year they are from. So because this has the ball that has the little, kind of looks like a quail's top on it down there, and the line, and it says Perfect Mason. I do like that ball has added the measurements on the side on the newer jars. But this one has put, so this puts this in the year, I think, 1930 to 1965, somewhere around there. Whoever canned these items probably bought these jars brand new the year that they were canning. So that's really cool. I'm going to pressure can some corn in these and we're going to give it a try. That's going to be in a separate video though. I'm going to take corn from the freezer and put it on my shelf. Oh, did I tell you? I ended up with 303 jars. Ah! I got 8 dozen quart ball jars. I got 6 dozen curd jars. And then quarts, and then I got about 2 dozen pints, and then the rest were just kind of mishmashed no brand jars from pickles, jellies, big old jars. So a total of 303. So far, one has broke and 2 have chips in the top, but that's all the damage I have found. Hopefully I can get all the rust off those super hard ones that are pretty rusted on. I'm gonna probably take a pipe wrench to some of those that I can't get off. Husband thinks that it's going to crush them and break them, but we'll give that a try. We'll try it on one and see how it works. Thanks for coming along and seeing me pick up these antique jars, figure out how to clean them, what to do with them, and now I get to use them and put food in them and put them on my shelf. I'm super happy, super excited. Thanks so much for being here and keeping me company while I go through this dirty job. And don't forget, if you're looking for a car canopy, make sure you give Vevor a try, and don't forget to use my link and my code for an exclusive discount. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll catch you next time on Mama Bairds.